Continuing on with our look into scripting, let's look at the switch statement and some other exciting Unity default functions that we will use a lot in making our games. Let's open up the response script and launch our script editor here. And let me show you exactly what the switch statement does. Let's say I have a variable called myvar and I set it to say hello. Now in my if statement, I want to check what the value of this variable is. So I'm saying if myvar equals equals hello. Notice that in an if statement, there you have to use double equal signs to check whether your value is the same as what the variable is holding. One equal sign in scripting means that you're setting the value. Two equals means that you're testing whether the value is true or not. Now, in this case, it might be correct because my if statement is set to hello and so is my variable. But what if I wanted to check more than only hello, for example, hi and howdy? In that case, I would have to ha add an else if and then say myvar equals equals howdy. And if my variable were set to howdy, then this would be true right now. And then if I wanted to check for another statement, I'd have to type this whole thing over again and say hi. Now, as you can see, this is quite a tedious progress having to say this little sentence, myvar equals equals, all the time. A switch statement cleans this up and makes things a lot easier. Switch statement goes like this: switch myvar, and then everything for the switch statement happens between these accolades. Now, as you can see, this is a lot cleaner. Instead of having to type the myvar equals equals all the time, I just say case it is hello. So in case it is hello, all the code that I need will be in between here and break. And break basically closes it just like accolades would in an if statement. Now I can add more case and break, and of course I can add as many as I want. So as you can see, a switch statement is a lot cleaner and nicer than multiple if statements would be. It just tidies things up a lot, and if when you're looking at other people's scripting, you don't want to see hundreds of else if statements, you just want to see a switch statement and make it clean and get it over with. Now, one more thing I want to show you is how to add comments. I can add comments in my script by typing two slashes like this. As you can see, my text turns green and I can say check if our character fell off the platform. Now, everything that is green or is typed in after these two slashes will not be performed as code in the engine. So whenever you want to tidy up your code and explain things, you can use comments like these to tidy things up. Now, last but not least, let's look at a couple of other functions that come standard with Unity. As you can see, there's the update function, which I have already explained. There's also some other functions like the late update, and it's basically the same thing. However, the late update is performed after the update function is called. So if you want to do something with code that has more priority over the update function, then usually you can use the late update function to correct things. Other than that, there's also a fixed update, and a fixed update is not called every frame because every frame per second is different per computer. For example, a laptop without a graphics card would have a lower frame rate than an extremely powerful device or a desktop computer. So therefore, if you're, for example, doing physics and you want to make a block fall from the sky manually, and you do this through frame rates, then in a small laptop it would fall slower than on a fast computer. And of course, if you're playing a multiplayer game, that would not be entirely fair. So therefore, we have invented the fixed update, and you can use this predefined Unity function to have a fixed time-based update function that you can use. However, it is most common to use the update function for most of the things and then use fixed update functions for only the heavy calculations as you don't want the fixed update to be playing with your computer's memory, as it is a little more intense. Then also we have an awake function, and remember that all scripts are attached to game objects, so the awake function is called before the update functions are called when the game is loading. So basically when the script is read for the first time. So if you want to set some base variables that you want to have active or true, then you can use the awake function. Now to make things interesting, and especially if you're used to, for example, a Adobe Flash background, there's also mouse commands that you can use, like on mouse enter function. And the on mouse enter happens when you hover your mouse over a object in the game. Now, if you want to check it while it is over the whole time, you use on mouse over. There's also an on mouse exit when you take your mouse off of an object. Then there's also a mouse down, which happens as soon as you click on an object. Now, this is, for example, very handy when you're making a strategy game or when you, for example, want to be able to pick things up. There's also an on mouse up, it's when you release the mouse button. And there's an on mouse drag, which is true as long as your mouse is pressed and you're, for example, dragging an object. On mouse drag, of course, is very handy to set the values to that of your mouse if you want to be able to drag things around in your game. So those are the functions that come with Unity. Let's move on and look at some of the core Unity classes.